I live with the pencil in my hand.
He was a doodler in school. Jimmy Gramlin caught grief from both teachers and parents for dreaming and drawing.
I remember my dad saying, "How you gonna make a living drawing stuff?"
So did Jake Purdom.
I've always drawn.
It's not surprising they found each other professionally through design. Jimmy hired Jake right out of school to help him work at his advertising firm.
You're creative director, and then I'm senior designer, as I get to say, in a two-person company.
Yeah.
Just me and the ocean.
Jimmy and his family actually moved to Hawaii for a year, but brainstorms are kind of like tropical storms. When everything lines up, you just can't stop the wave. You can only ride it.
At the core, we're artists. In everything that we do, it starts with an art form.
A tropical storm knocked down some eucalyptus trees in Hawaii. Jimmy and Jake together started selling sunglasses cut from the dead wood. Gramblin moved back home to Oklahoma, brought some wood with him, and even more ideas rolled in with the tide.
We saw a connection between Native American and Polynesian and South American tribal designs.
Before you knew it, those designs were making their way onto other things made of wood. Earrings, cufflinks, pins, bracelets. They call their company Moku, which means island in Hawaiian, and brought island life back to the shores of Keystone Lake.
We washed up here.
Jimmy still has his advertising clients, and now their little two-man operation is using tropical brainstorms and Oklahoma storms too. They're using locally cut bow dark wood, cypress, and oak to make more jewelry.
It really has been a process of discovery.
The Moku name keeps growing, kind of like branches on a tree, seeking sunlight and always trending up. Near Sand Springs, Galen Culver, News 4. Is this a great state or what?